Hi, my name is Chris and this is Battle Nonsense. Less than 2 weeks ago, Epic Games released patch 4.2 for Fortnite, which not only increased the tickrate of the game servers to a fairly stable 30 Hz, it also significantly reduced the network delay. You can find a link to my netcode analysis for that patch in the description down below. Now, last week, PUBG received update 14, which got many players very excited as some noticed that the send rate of the game servers now maxed out at 60 instead of 30 Hz. And as a result, some players were quick to say that PUBG now runs at a tickrate of 60 Hz. But that is sadly not the case, because it fails to provide a send rate of 60 Hz at all times. If you don't know what the tickrate of a game server is, or if you are unfamiliar with terms like update rates, lag compensation, packet loss or latency variation, or if you have never seen one of my other netcode analysis videos before, then I would like to encourage you to watch my netcode 101 video, where I explain all these networking basics, as well as how I do my network delay tests. The reason why I no longer include this basic information in every video is that my viewers requested that I put that into a separate video in order to reduce the length of the actual netcode analysis video. So you can find a link to that video in the description down below, and there's also a card overlay in the top right corner which takes you directly to that video. Now, when we take a look at the network data from Fortnite, then since patch 4.2 the server's send rate mostly stays above 30 Hz no matter how many players are alive. In PUBG, on the other hand, the server's update rate is still strongly affected by the number of players who are running around on the map. Just that before update 14, the server's send rate would drop down to 8 Hz when the match began, and then slowly increase as the player count dropped. Eventually, it would then reach a maximum send rate of 30 Hz. Now, after update 14, the send rate of the server is still affected by the player count, as you can see here, but it mostly stays above 20 Hz, which is a big step in the right direction. Then, as the player count drops, the send rate of the server increases until it eventually reaches 60 Hz now. However, it fails to maintain a stable send rate of 60 Hz, and this is why the statement that PUBG would now run at a tick rate of 60 Hz is simply wrong. But not just the send rate of the server was increased in this update. The game client also sends updates more frequently now, about 97 updates per second. So by sending data more frequently, you decrease the delay between the server and the client, but you also increase the traffic between the two. But when you look at the bandwidth usage from before and after the latest update, then most players should not run into any issues here, even now when the servers send up to 60 updates per second. But how does this change affect the network delay that two players are affected by when they play on the same server at a ping of 25 milliseconds each? In my last test, I measured an average delay of 97.5 milliseconds for damage, 94.5 milliseconds for gunfire, and 99.5 milliseconds for player movement when there were less than 40 players left, which meant that the server sent 30 updates per second to the players. Update 14 did not only lower the average network delays, it also made them more consistent, as the difference between the shortest, average, and longest delays is much smaller now. However, these are the results from my tests when there were less than 40 players alive, and so the server sends between 50 to 60 updates per second to the players. When there are more than 85 players alive, then the server is only able to send about 20 updates per second, and the players suffer from very long network delays, as you can see here. I did repeat these tests multiple times, on different live servers and on both maps, but the results were always roughly the same. So, even when you have a low ping to the game server, you will still have a lot of lag and desync issues, especially during the early stages of the match, which result in some weird gameplay moments. Then, when there are less than 40 players alive, the delays do get better, but they are still very long when compared to the current version of Fortnite, which is able to provide very low delays at all times, no matter how many players are still alive. So, with update 14, PUBG finally received an update that actually improved the network delay, but the results are far from great, especially during the first half of the match. I think that the developers should try and cap the server's send rate at 30 Hz and get the servers to run at that rate throughout the entire match before they then increase the rate further. Fortnite shows that the player-to-player network delay is affected by more than just how frequently the game sends and receives updates, as Fortnite provides much shorter network delays at a server send rate of just 30 Hz. I also want to ask the developers to finally show the players their ping to the game server, inbound as well as outbound packet loss, and the send rates of the client and the server, like Epic Games does in Fortnite. Otherwise, it's very frustrating for players as they don't know if they got killed because their internet connection had an issue or if there was an issue with the game. This info will also help the developers when they look at the gameplay footage from the players. Providing those network statistics is good for everyone, and the Unreal Engine basically provides that info already. Also, don't be surprised when you still die behind cover, especially during the early stages of the match, as the lag compensation remains unchanged in this update, which means that it still favors the shooter, even when the receiving player has a very low ping to the game server. I really wish that more games would have a threshold for how much lag the game compensates, like Battlefield 1 has, which I explained in my Netcode 101 video. And that's all for today. I will keep you updated on the progress that the developers make, and if you enjoyed this quick update on PUBG's network delay, then it would be great if you could support me on Patreon, as YouTube's ad revenue is sadly not enough anymore to run a niche channel like mine. Without the awesome support that I get from my patrons, I could not do videos like my input lag analysis for keyboards and other exciting topics that no other channel investigates. So if you like what I do, then you can find the link to my Patreon in the description down below, where you will also find links to my social accounts in case that you want to stay up to date on the videos that I'm working on. So if you enjoyed this video, then please give it a like, subscribe for more, and I hope to see you next time. Until then, have a nice day and take care. My name is Chris, and this was Battle Nonsense.